to him. Many were on the path of death. Many were serving the devil, even without them knowing they were serving the devil. But Jesus Christ located you and I on a particular day. Touch your heart and move you back into the loving arms of the Master. That is what he did for you and for me. That is what he did both for children yet unborn. Today is a special day in the life of our sister, our mother, our friend, our pastor. And we join her in singing that song. Savior, the one whom you saved has come to worship you. There are so many people who are saved or who want to be saved and who do not have the means to worship. He has chosen the right path. Rather than focusing on the food and the drink, has chosen this day that he's laying it up to the Master to worship him, to come and say thank you. Thank you for my life. He's come to say thank you for what I've done. I was on the path of failure and you located me. You located me and you turned my life around. So we are here to celebrate with her.
Yes.
To celebrate life.
Amen.
To celebrate victory.
Amen.
To celebrate freedom.
Amen.
To celebrate liberty.
Amen.
Liberty to become who the Lord God has proposed her to become. You know what, as I sat down and when the pastor just a few minutes ago said, you know, you're going to speak. And the Lord dropped Psalm 121 into my heart. You'd wonder, what would Psalm 121 have to do with what we are doing this evening or this evening? Psalm 121 is written for pilgrims who are on the journey. My sister, you are on a journey. The first part of the journey has come and gone. I want to enjoin you to wipe away your tears. Yes, I understand. I do understand. Some of us not, some of us not. But there is a journey ahead of you. And we sang another song, My Helper, Oh, My Helper. Which is the essence of the few minutes that I have. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From where is coming my help? My help. The Lord is helping me to tell you, my dear sister, that you have a journey ahead of you. And help will not come from man. Because man does not have the capability to help you to achieve what he has in store for you. Oh yes, the challenges are going to come. Oh yes, fear will come. But the Lord is saying this evening that I am Jehovah Ebenezer. The one who is capable, the one who knows the end from the beginning, the one who is quite beyond the power of his hands, says to say, I will help you. Says to say, I will uphold you. Says to tell you that I will provide succor for you. He is a fully breasted one. All the milk you need is from him. He's calling this day, this celebration day, that come and suck from my breast and you will receive life. Come and suck from me, you will receive wisdom. I mean, you need a lot of wisdom because of the so many projects that are in front of you. So many challenges are coming. You might wonder on a day of bad day, but this is the truth. Challenges even in the ministry. are coming. But the fully breasted one is saying, look up to me. I am going to sustain you. If you partner with me as you have partnered, if you do not believe that it is your ability that has enabled you, or your righteousness that has taken you to where you are, I am giving you victory in the name of Jesus Christ. Friends will come, friends will try to move you away from the path that the Lord has laid for you. But he's saying, look up to me, so that the sun and the moon will not smite you by day, neither will this night smite you by night. Simply because everything that is created of God, he has made to be a help unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. The resources that he made are there for you to provide for you, such that what you want to achieve for him, those whom you want to feed, those whose the lives that you want to change, the lives that you want to impact, the resourceful resourcer is saying, from the left and from the right, even from places where you do not expect it, what you need will come to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. So, like I said, it's a short one. It's just to let you to understand that it says it shall preserve you from all evil. It shall preserve your soul.
Amen.
What does that mean? It shall preserve your soul. The soul is the essence of your being. Even though, yes, you have a spirit, but the soul is you, the seat of your emotions. Where the attacks come from the left and from the right. Where the attacks come from the front and from the back. Where challenges come such that one might decide, I am not doing the game. Oh, I am tired. Oh, I am giving up. But the Lord is saying, I will preserve your soul.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He said he will preserve your going out, and he will preserve your coming in from this time forth. From this time forth, and now says, even forevermore.
Amen.
Even forevermore.
Amen.
So I want to encourage you, my dear sister, that you ain't seen nothing yet.
Amen.
Challenges are going to come big time.
Yes.
So also the blessings of God, the resources of God, the overcoming presence of the Master will keep you and will sustain you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You know, the help that you need, it will provide for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Finally, it says, using scripture, teach me to number my days.
Yeah.
So every day from today is vital. Some of us live in fear because we believe when we get to a certain age, rather than thinking of the almightiness of God, we are thinking it is every day closer to our death. Oh yes. There are people who think like that. You know, because the people around us are begging us one after the other. And rather than appreciating God, where will my tongue be? It's just what people think about. But teach me to number my days. Simply tells you, my dear sister, that every day on earth is vital. And each and every one of us is going to make an account of it. Even our thoughts, even our deeds, even the things we were not able to do when we should have done them, is going to question us. But I know that with the help of the Master, you know, our sister will overcome. Our sister will make it.
Amen.
And on that day when Jesus Christ comes, she will be one of those who will go with him.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Can we pray this afternoon? Or this still afternoon? Evening. Evening. Savior. Taking time out to bow before you this evening. and worship you. We saints join hands with us to say thank you, O my Father. Thank you, my Father, for giving her your Son, paying the supreme price for her to make eternity. Of course, that is the perfect one. But while you are on earth, to fulfill our purpose, to make a difference, to touch lives of all those who come into contact with her, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, she's doing her bit by your grace. Father, we'll thank you. For our marriage, we'll thank you. For our children, spiritual children, biological children, we'll thank you. For friends and family who identify with your daughter, Father, we'll thank you. For the church of God, Father, we'll thank you. Father, we are believing you that the church whom you have given unto her, Father, will grow from grace to grace, will grow from strength to strength, in the name of Jesus. Father, the city in which you have planted your daughter will know this time of hope. Because a new one has risen today to impact lives around the city, to impact lives around the state, in the name of Jesus. Father, the rest of the evening is in your hands. Father, tomorrow is in your hands. We know we have done the needful by putting you first. Father, remember this day for good. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. I will give you praise. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Let's put our hands together to give praise to God. Wonderful time. We all came to celebrate life. We didn't come to get that or more. That's the reason why we rejoice tonight. Because you have your life. And God has given you 50. And God will add more and more, more and more, until when all that you came to do is done.
Amen.
Amen.
I want you us, we are going to end this session, but I want us to do it this way. I really want us to pray to the woman of God. I want us to begin to say, you came because of her. And I want you, not only physical gift, I want you to sow prayer to her life. I want you to put your holy hands towards her and begin to plead the blood of Jesus. And begin to decree and declare whatever you want to see happen to God. The grace of God to manifest. The glory of God to manifest. The joy of the Lord to manifest. The power of God to manifest. The greatness of God to manifest. Yes, Lord. Our heads will stop. Yes, Lord. Everything the Lord has in place for her, that she begins. The ministry God has commanded, given unto you to prosper. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Everywhere you go. Yes, Lord. People, we know that the child of the Most High God is there. In the name of Jesus. Your life will make an impact. In the name of Jesus. Every word that you speak, those words shall be uttered. They shall make everything that God has spoken to do
does what we begin to create and to create and to recreate. All the things in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we declare tonight that it shall be well with your daughter. Thank you, Jesus. Take all the glory, Lord, tonight. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Heavenly Father, we give you the glory, we give you all the praise. Because of the life that you spared.
Yes.
A life that you poured into.
Yes.
You are the one that has strengthened her.
Yes.
You are the one that took her from an infertile soil.
Yes.
And you brought her to a soil.
Yes.
Like the scripture said in Psalm. It said you are like a tree planted.
Yes.
You are not just like you are. A tree planted by the riverside, you shall lack nothing.
Amen.
You will not lack joy.
Amen.
You will not lack peace.
Amen.
You will not lack resources.
Amen.
Whatsoever you lay your hands upon shall prosper.
Amen.
I decree and I declare
Amen.
That it shall be well with you,
Amen.
With your children,
Amen.
With your home,
Amen.
With your family.
Amen.
Everywhere you go,
Amen.
It shall be well with you.
Amen.
People will see you, they will want to identify with your God. Every word you speak shall be powerful.
Yeah.
It shall go through the bone.
Yeah.
It shall go through life.
Yeah.
And bring life
yeah.
from wherever they have been abandoned.
Yeah.
And give life to them.
Yeah.
The Bible says to Ezekiel,
Amen.
It said, can this bone sleep?
Yeah.
Ezekiel said, yes, Lord.
Yes.
It is you. So tonight, Lord, we speak that word into the life of your daughter.
Yeah.
That as she begins to speak to dry bones,
yes.
along that Atlanta, life shall come upon them.
Soul
shall be won for you.
Amen.
The kingdom of darkness has no power over her.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we are thanking you tonight.
Amen.
We are giving you the glory.
Amen.
We are giving you the praise.
Amen.
Everyone that came here today, you are going home with joy.
Amen.
Joy shall be your portion.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Salvation is your portion.
Amen.
The light and salvation has come upon your home. Marriages are restored. Wounds are being opened. Lives are being changed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You came for a life.
Amen.
That life you are going as well.
Amen.
Life in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Life. The Bible says there is life in the blood.
Yes.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
For that life that has come to be upon your daughter. Strength in the name of Jesus to carry on until Jesus tarries. In the name of Jesus to continue from 50, 200, 120. You will not know sickness. All day sickness shall not come to you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And we pray in Jesus' name. And you put your hands together to celebrate. Jesus is Lord. He's our God. He's our life. Forevermore. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Can you all be seated, please? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for taking time for this wonderful night. I would like to take one or two people who want to testify to the goodness of living life. That God has healed, restored, that God has given 50 years. Is there anyone here that wants to say anything? Do you want to say a word? Do you want to...
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Today is a great day in our household.
Hallelujah.
My dear sister. I wanted to let you know, I never told you this before, that I was very grateful. Let me tell you, I would have been gone. It was in this house that my brother, Pastor Peter, came to get me when I was sick. And he was Pastor Peter that lost me.
Hallelujah.
In life. Father God, Jesus, I thank God for your life. Thank God for your life. God will continue to bless you abundantly.
Amen.
Put your hands together. Anyone? As it was said, anybody, do you want to say something?
Shall we come for tomorrow?
Okay.
Tomorrow.
You want to say something?
I might
see. Amen. I just thank God for the life of Pastor Bunmi. I really thank God for her life. She is, I don't even know the words to use to describe her. I thank God for everything that you have done, your selfless love, unconditional love for everyone that you do, even regardless, you don't, it doesn't even take you a minute for you to do it. I remember the very first time that I met her, I was actually visiting an aunt in Augusta, and Pastor Peter was like, oh, I moved to Atlanta, then I'm in Suwannee, and we were going to come, we just drove. And that's how I met her. And I just thank God that from the moment that I met her, my life has been blessed because Amen. She has poured so much into me. Yes. Not the prayers, word, encouragement, that sometimes I will be thinking, does this woman like me? I'm like, does she love me? What? And I'm like, my mom always say, the ones that you love are the ones you scroll the most. Amen. And I thank you for all that you have done.
Amen.
And all that God is still going to do in your life. Amen. Even in your ministry, this is just the beginning.
Amen.
I pray that God will do great and greater Amen. Works through you.
Amen.
Through your hands, through your mouth, through Amen. Your body, through your spirit, through your soul. God will use you mightily.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I really appreciate you and love you.
Amen.
Let's put our hands together.
Amen.
Anyone else? Auntie, do you want to say something? Oh, bless you. That
will
be the last ones that
I'll
be.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's a honor to be here to celebrate my sister. She's shaking her head. She's been my prayer partner for a while, for a very long time.
Hallelujah.
And I mean my prayer partner.
Thank you, Jesus.
I live in Nigeria. And so I'm in Nigeria and she's here. So we always find time. And anytime, even when I have issues, and it's whatever it is, I will just call her and we will dedicate time to intercede and to the glory of God. Every time when we come together as touching anything as the word of God sees, he's always doing it. I celebrate you, my sister. I celebrate you. I celebrate God in your life. And I pray that the grace would increase continually in the name of Jesus. Your anointing will not run dry.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will grow from glory to glory,
Amen.
From strength to strength,
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together. We are now going to call Pastor Peter, the set man of the house.
Yes.
Thank you.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
I think we're at the end.
Yes.
Okay. We want to thank everybody very much for showing up tonight to honor God in the life of my beautiful, lovely, fantastic. Wait now, should I go on? Gorgeous.
Keep it coming.
Woman of the Lord. Powerful woman of the Lord. I won't give you all, I'll wait for tomorrow to release the rest. She wants me to continue. Amen.
Amen.
We appreciate you all.
Amen.
With the love of the Lord. And we thank God for what he has been doing for my wife and ourselves. And I appreciate her. I love her very much.
Amen.
And as a token of the Lord,
no.
I want to present something to her. Let your hallelujah be louder.
Amen.
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 Amen. And all of you are going to be witnesses. Saying thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, my Lord. We are saying thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
my Lord. We are saying thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. We are saying thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. We are saying
appreciate you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. And I'm sure whenever I turn left or right, I see you all the time. You are the apple of my eyes, the sugar of my tea. I think DJ TUNDE has something to say.
Everybody say yeah. All right, I don't see church. All right. Men like Pastor Peter make men like me and the other men look very bad in front of their wives. Well, man, I improve, Ken. Do they know?
No.
We've been strategizing about this fantastic, incredible, captivating, motivating, invigorating, tantalizing, intoxicating. You mean Papita be on TV? Let's see what's inside. Can you? You see, I have inside knowledge. That is why I said men like Pastor make men like us look like Jaleo.
No, you are unique in your own way.
No, not with this kind of money.
Not with this kind of. Not that, sorry.
Sweetheart,
are you listening?
Yeah. Sure.
Sweetheart, are you listening?
Yeah.
shiver. If you don't feel the body, let it shiver. And you know we don't give up. Like a rush, you'll find me in the club. Bottles full of buzz, my mind got what you need. You can even feel the buzz. I'm gonna have the same time, you can make it up. Don't give me a hug, you're in the getting lost. You can find me in the club. Bottles full of buzz, my mind got what you need. When I pull up, I touch you, the beat don't work. When I pull up 20 feet, don't come in the club. Yeah, I got my train, everybody show me love. You feel like you're in the middle, you're in the middle. There's no game, nothing changed, no doubt. Be with the team, give it in the middle, man, roll the trees. I'm running back, time moving, it's the 4K up here. They hit me, you feel it, now I'm walking the left. In the room, and that nigga saying, you hot. They like me, I want me to love me like they love hot. But I live in New York, it's your day, I'm local. In the plane, it's the back end, and it's so far, I'm fully focused, man. My money on my mind, got a meal out the deal, and I'm feeling the grind.
Joy be Ijoko Oya Bunmi Pastor. Yeah? And here, that's what we are doing. She's just to talk now. Madam, we are waiting for you. Oya.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brethren, good evening. Our daddies, our mommies, everybody, my family. Thank you all. I have no words to say how grateful I am. Usually, I don't celebrate birthdays. But I tell you what, this is one birthday that I've heard happy birthday the most in my lifetime. I don't even think that a day like this could happen. I've been through so much. So much, so much, so much in life. I'm just grateful to God. The fact that I'm alive today is a miracle. Everything about me is very different from every normal person. You know, you would expect you to have a daughter that goes to school, that graduates, that gets married, that have children, that have all of this stuff. But you see, I just realized that mine has been different. It didn't go that way. But still in everything, in all of it, I see the hand of God.
Yeah. Preach it, sister, preach it.
I might not be available for my, when we start college, what do they call it in Nigeria?
Jambite
in matriculation. I wasn't there for some unknown reason. I missed that day. Graduation, I was not there. You know, it's just different things. But God, in His infinite mercy, He makes His word true and sure. Even in the most difficult situations, it shows the light. You know, my life is a testimony. People might not understand why I am thanking God today. I think that a lot of times I could have been dead and gone. When I think of the things that the Lord had brought me out of and brought me through. I know when I don't have food, no food. No food, and I have my siblings with me. No food in the house at all. And, you know, we lost our mom when we were young, and it was just my dad. And we will be thinking, and there's time when my dad will come and say, Bunmi, this is all I have. Go to the market and make this work. And I go to the market and I come back and I cook. And I look at my siblings and there's not enough food and I stay hungry. And I sit down and I watch them eat and I'll be happy. Yeah.
And I wait for my daddy to hit. My daddy will hit and I'll be happy. And he will ask me, he said, Bunmi, are you okay? I said, I'm okay. And he will always bless me. He always pray for me. And that prayer, I know that it went all the way. All the way, I'm telling you. All the way, doors that I can't imagine opens for me. Even when the least person I expect disappoints me, God shows up in a big way. Every time, he has always been there for me, and I'm grateful to God. When I met the Lord, it was a major turning. Actually, I met the Lord before, and I strayed away. I'm not one of those pleasant stories that tell you I got born again at 14, I stayed born again. No. I got born again early, I didn't stay born again. But later, I came back to the Lord. But when the Lord got me, he got me good. When he spoke to me, you know, when I came back to, I'm just like a real prodigal child. When I came back to God, it's like everything, more than I can imagine, he released onto me. And I just thank him. I want to thank God for every one of you here today. I know it is God that has brought us together. And I know it is God that has made this day possible. And I want to thank God for the family that the Lord has blessed me with. I can't begin to tell you stories about my life. I tell people, I say, if I open my mouth to tell you my story, then you will know that of a truth there is a God that lives in Israel. But that God is faithful. I don't know what you are passing through today, but know that there is always light at the end of the tunnel. The Bible says, if crying endure for one night, joy comes in the morning. And that morning does not take forever. That morning comes. It doesn't matter if you are standing alone, stand. In the whole of this America, there was a time I was going through so much. I almost killed myself. I was in so much, I just felt so lonely and I had so much trouble. And I told God, I said, God, do you mean that in the whole of this world, you cannot send me one person to tell me that you still hear me? And you know what happened? She called me, she was going to Jesse. She called me, she said, the Lord told me I have to make it to Atlanta tonight. She changed her flight from Nigeria to come to Atlanta. She stayed 3 days, she did not eat. She only drank tea and she prayed throughout. She prayed me through that cloud. She helped me to stand in the Lord. And I thank God. I thank God for, you know, different friends at different times. I remember when I came to America the first time. I'll tell you my story. Please permit me. The first time I came to America, I came for a conference in Washington, D.C. And I came for a conference and I had a vacation. And that vacation was a month. And I came to see my ex and I got pregnant with Tosin. I went back to Nigeria. When I came back within 4 months, he said he had gone with somebody else, I should find my level. And I was pregnant for 6 months when I came back. I came back in April, end of April. And when I came back end of April, I had nothing, I had no one, I had God. My son was in Nigeria with my parents, with my dad, and I was pregnant with Tosin. I didn't have nothing, nobody, but I had God. Some of my friends, I think Lola was still a student then. I don't know where she came about $500 that she sent to me. She said, buy a bassinet for your baby. I don't know where she got it from because she didn't have money. She was a student, but she, you know, she showed up. God sent people all the way throughout. And I just want to thank God. My siblings, I can't thank them enough. You know, my brother is probably on his way somewhere, you know, he stood by me. Every time, he made it an habit to call me every night, going to work 1 hour. So he became my companion. We were friends for a long time. You know, until I married my husband, I stopped talking to him. You know, but every night he would call me and talk to me for a whole hour to work. You know? You know, my sisters, you know, they've been a blessing. You know, it's just amazing. And the surprising thing is, I hardly celebrate, but when I wanted to get married and I told a few friends, I said, I'm getting married. All of them stood up and said, I'll be there, I'll be there. Just like this birthday,
I said I wanted to do volunteer. I wanted to just, you know, celebrate, just thank God, bring people together and just praise the Lord. And you know, everyone that I spoke with, they said they were going to be here. Auntie Bumi came on a short notice all the way from Wolverhampton. You know, our mommy, mommy from Maryland, God bless you, ma. You know, my story is small compared to you, but you know that I've been through a little, no. I thank you. The Lord will sustain you and uphold you. Your faith, it will uphold you and make your life to be sweeter. Your end of your life will be sweeter than the beginning. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Our mama, shine, shine, mama, Abiona. You see all the light? She's my designer. All the way from London. You know, Pastor Tubi, I spoke to him. I said, I'm having a party. And he said he'll be there. After his mom passed, he went to Nigeria. He came to LA after. Within 3 weeks, this man has come back to America. It is just the grace of God. Thank you, sir. God bless you. Our Olori Ebi here, our daddy, the one, the only Olaniran standing, our big eldest Olaniran, Olori Ebi, we thank you. God bless you, sir. God bless you and your madam for your support. We thank you. Everybody, I thank you. Murphy and Madam Kemi, oh my God. Kemi cooks the best vegetable ever. This couple took me in their house when I had a job in New York about 11 years ago. You know, thank you so much. And I've not seen them since that time. Thank you so much. I love you so much. Thank you. And our Auntie Adiola and Uncle, God bless you. Thank you so much. Oh my God, my dear Joke. She's just a replica of Dotun. Her character is just Dotun. My sister is called Dotun. Sister Joke is just the same as her. Thank you so much. God bless you. And your husband, your family, we appreciate you. Thank you, Pastor Tayo. Mommy Odubonojo, God bless you. DJ Tunde brought me to this point, this birthday. Last year, he called me and said he's blocking his calendar, he's going to DJ in Atlanta for my 50th. And I'm like, how can you come and DJ? I'm not having a party. But he kept telling me, you're having that party and I'm coming to Atlanta. Thank you so much. God bless you. This is my husband's friendship, the best friendship. Oh God, my dear Joker, we've come a long way. I love you, girl. She's so sweet. This is my friend, the only door I knock anytime in London. Be it 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 2 a.m., without notice, I press the bell, they open the door. Thank you, God bless you. Madam Abioro, the only fashionable in our house. That's my sister. She's not my immediate, I have one in between us. But she's like very protective of me. She doesn't want nobody around. Madam Abioro, God bless you. I love you, sweetie. My Daniel bought his own ticket with his own money all the way from London. If I tell you I have a boyfriend, believe me, that's my boyfriend. He said, Mommy B, I'm coming. I gotta come, you know, ain't it? And I'm serving some money. I gotta make it. Thank you, darling. I appreciate you. Simisola, oh my God. Our parents are best friends. Simisola Famaki. And now, Brother Kenny married her. Yeah, Adebayo. She's now Mrs. Adebayo. You know, our parents are friends. From childhood, we too were friends. We will continue to be friends forever in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. She's always very supportive. Ah, hey, where's my friendship? Come out. Thank you. God bless you, Sister Bimbo. I appreciate this woman of God. She's so supportive. Thank you for everything. God bless you and your family. We love you. Love you. Brother Damola, I love you. God bless you. Molade, thank you. Everybody, Brother Steve, Brother Kule. Ah, Sister Yetunde, my in-law. Hey, my only superstar. Please let me greet her there. Thank you. I appreciate you all. Be encouraged. The Lord will help us. In Jesus' name. Amen. I love my husband. Thank you for the Rolex. More to come. Yes. Oh, no worry. Yes. Thank you for everything, for your support, for your love. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. I bless the Lord for your life. And I want, oh yes, I'm coming there. I'm coming there. It's this, you know, we're around there. Come to family. This now is family caucus. Yes. Wait. Today, let me finish this one. It's very important. See, my husband is very shy, so I'm even surprised he did all of this. See, we see me here, we go and stand there. I'm looking from afar. But anyway, thank you. Love and appreciate you. God bless you. I want to thank God also for my, oh God, amazing son. The most handsome. Oh. Tell you something. I don't take one single credit for this boy. It is all God. It is all God. I don't even think I trained you. I think God by himself trained you. And I remember before I had him, God told me he was going to give me a gift of a child. And told me a lot of things about this boy. I'm like, where is this dada boy following me about? In my sleep, I'm always seeing dada. I'll be warning him, go back. Before I knew it, I was pregnant with Michael. He came out, I'm like, where's the dada? I didn't see dada. I said, okay, maybe he's not the one. But the hair keeps coiling, I keep looking. You see, I don't talk to dada. I thank God for your life. I appreciate you. You know, you are a blessing, a huge blessing. I don't think I deserve it, but God just gave me. And I thank God for you. And my beautiful, oh God, my beautiful toast. Thank you for your love, for your kindness. What a beautiful soul, kind heart. I thank you. God bless you. God will continue to uphold all of you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Wait, I don't need a microphone. You were saying something about your husband. I wanted to interrupt you.
Okay.
Fabi. I'm sorry. There's a reason. Hey, sorry, this is very serious. There's a reason why Peter is a pastor right now. So can bring people like me to Jesus.
So, okay.
We have something for both of you.
Have you come to Jesus?
Hey, boy, you better make Bible before you know.
Music.
I wanna build my whole world around.
go because I could munch all your drugs tonight. Alright, we're going to say the grace. Before we start partying, there is juice, there is Coca-Cola, there is Fanta, and there is anything there for you.
Tosi.
Andrew. I'll share the grace. She's over there. Everybody's over there. Almighty God.
Yes.
Amen. Our Father will bless your name for who you are. Thank you because you are a glorious God.
Amen.
Well, thank you because in your awesomeness you do not fail us. In all that we have commissioned to your hand, you have helped us. Lord, you helped us to plan and you helped us to execute. Thank you because our way is in you. Every step of the way you unfold unto us. And Father, I want to thank you for this stage that you have unfolded in the life of your daughter. We pray that the grace of God will abound in her life. The presence of God will never depart. And Lord Almighty, your glory will go with her.
Amen.
Wheresoever she goes.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
All that we have planned tomorrow, we commit into your hands. That Almighty God, you will guide us.
Amen.
Father, people will come well, they will go well.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We cancel every satanic accident.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We nullify every power of darkness.
Amen.
Our celebration will be great.
Amen.
Today, tonight, we enjoy ourselves.
Amen.
Tomorrow, we enjoy ourselves.
Amen.
And we'll give all the glory to
Amen.
You. And we'll say, in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Now help me prophesy to somebody and say to them, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Thank you all. The party is now declared open.
For those of you that think that gospel music has gone too far,